More recently, I think we've discovered additional uses for Botox that are not quite as common, including to raise the corner of the mouth. We selectively weaken the muscles in the corner that pull the lips down as we get older. So if you ever see somebody with an inverted curve in their mouth, they can really be helped by the addition of a little Botox here and here. Another common area for usage is in the chin. People complain about dimples in their chin. It's usually from muscle action of a muscle called the mentalis, and we can weaken that and make the chin look a lot smoother. Would you like to hear some more?
I would.
Usual
I
uses?
would. Yeah, that would be fantastic. Yeah, it's fascinating to learn that it's been used to treat migraines as well. What are some of the other less frequently known uses for it?
Well, in my practice, I also will sometimes inject the platysma muscle because many people over 40 get bands in their neck. And most people think it's simply droopy skin, but in fact, it's a muscle that's under spasm. So if we selectively inject the bands of the muscle, we can often make a near smooth or sometimes a perfectly smooth neck, making somebody look 10 or 15 years younger after just a 15-minute treatment.
Wow. And how long does the treatment usually last? Is it fairly consistent no matter where it's applied, or is it differ depending on where it's applied?
Well, it does depend upon the area where it's used, the individual, and how strong the individual muscles are that we're trying to treat. For example, we can also inject along the jawline to weaken the platysma muscle to give a nicer edge to the jawbone, just allow it to be seen better as the muscle flattens. Some patients, especially in Asia, who have very thick masseter muscles, don't like the width of their face, can have Botox injected to thin the muscle temporarily and also to help temporomandibular or TMJ joint problems. So it's a very useful tool, and we're finding increasing techniques to use that can help our patients in a
Interesting.
safe way, too. I have to emphasize, my feeling is if reasonable doses are used, it's very safe and potentially very beneficial.